Welcome to the Horror Movie Showdown, episode 50. As this is the 50th episode of the showdown, I wanted to do something a bit different. So I invited two friends over for the authentic Ebbemonster Horror Fun experience. And we watched the two 80s slasher movies, Intruder and Blood Rage, which I've used clips for several of my showdown intros. In this video, the three of us break down the movies together and declare a winner. Let's jump straight into our thoughts on the two movies.
What we're going to discuss now is the two movies we have just watched. Two slasher movies.
Yes.
The first one was?
I don't even know what. The first one was Intruder?
Yes, Intruder. Yeah.
There you go. Thanks a lot.
And the other one was something about some some blood.
Alright, so
Blood Rage?
You tell us about what
blood
happened
rage.
In the first one.
Yes.
Yes. So some guys go to a discount store, and then there's a killer, and he kills people using stuff in the store. I don't know. It's like there's not really a plot. It's like an ex-boyfriend who comes to the store and wants to make up with his girlfriends, but then they hunt him out, and then for the rest of the movie you believe he's the killer, but maybe he's not the killer, or maybe he's the killer, or yeah, that's basically
it. Kind of think he's the killer.
You're crazy.
Yeah, you kind of think he's the killer because he killed someone a year
but
before.
Then instead the killer is the mustache guy who we see earlier getting hit really hard with a metal hammer
right in the head.
But then later he has no damage, and then he was the
which
killer.
Actually makes sense when you think of that he's being hit in his head maybe five times with five different heavy objects, and he always recovers within 2 or 3 minutes. So I just think he must be really thick-headed.
Yeah, the scene with the butcher's knife where they hit him like 10 times in the face and then he just wakes up again. So maybe he's a pretty robust kind of guy.
Alright. And otherwise I think it's just about young people having fun on the job, doing what they do, make some jokes to each other. They work it too. Did you wonder about that? They work so many hours after the supermarket was closed, and none of them was really doing
it. Not really explained that, like opening boxes, moving boxes, and closing them again, and not really doing anything, like putting stuff on shelves and then pushing it off as jokes, and then picking it up and putting it up again, and then making the same joke again, pushing it off again, and then ha ha ha, that's funny, and then yeah, and then the guy who cuts the watermelon, and then he cuts it up and starts eating it, and then you're like, is it his job to cut the watermelon, or is he just hungry?
And there's only one watermelon. Like, it's his job to cut like one watermelon. That's
yeah, his job was basically to cut up vegetables in the basement after the shop is closed, listening to music, not going anywhere with the just cut vegetables in the basement.
Yeah.
One watermelon.
He also cuts other stuff. It's like the scene where he gets killed. It's like chopping, like really exaggerated, and then suddenly you don't see what he's chopping, but his face is chopped. So maybe he's chopping some more watermelons.
Hello? Why are you so international?
Because we're doing the videos.
Video review.
Video review.
That definitely goes in, right?
Of course. It's one long take, a 1 hour movie.
So, what I liked about the movie was... I think if you like movies and appreciate the awkwardness of movies, this movie is an excellent movie. Actually, I would say then it's quite good.
He started stealing money from me. And then he needed more money to buy drugs. I mean, like, very serious drugs.
I think you gave it a pretty bad rating.
Okay, what was up? Okay, all they have so many boxes with empty cans, with empty soda cans in the supermarket.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
It is pretty interesting. And then the camera worked, like they're filming out from inside the phone and then out in the floor or something where there's like the broom is going over the camera.
It's very, what do you call it, voyeur.
Voyeuristic.
How many kills did we get in the Intruder?
I think it was 7 or 8. 8 kills, I think. If the last guy
died. So we found out that... So there were 2 kills in the beginning. The girl who was by the car.
Yeah.
And then the guy who was hit in the head by the hammer. We were almost sure the guy who was hit in the head by the hammer was killed, but we were not sure about the girl. Well, then it turned out that the guy who was hit in the head by the hammer, he did not suffer any damage at all, like zero. There was nothing.
He didn't even have a bump or anything in his
no
head.
Impact at all. But I think the girl by the car actually was.
It's like they show that she's cut, but then before she gets cut, they cut to the watermelon. And then you don't know if she's dead, but it's kind of implied.
It's a bit weird that they did that because all the other kills they show very explicitly.
Maybe the watermelon was a metaphor.
It's a metaphor for like, I'll let you elaborate on that.
Did you ever see her being dead?
Yeah, she shows up in the trunk or something with a like.
It's a knife in her chest that.
Okay.
But main character grabs in the end to defend herself.
Yeah.
You also have to talk about the joke.
The which one?
Like the he pretended like he had the head of a dead guy
and the sandwich.
Yeah, that was really funny actually.
Oh, that was also the sandwich. But the like he was like pretending, help, it's me. He was like having this dead head. And then of course the hearing came to look at what it was.
Just me. I'm just pretending.
Okay, I'm gonna kill you now. It was a prank.
It's a pretty good prank.
Said, but it was pretty good.
Yeah.
Like actually, I'm gonna.
So
like the problem is there's nothing good. Like there was nothing. Like the kills are cool.
Yeah.
But there's not really anything else of substance in any of the characters. Or...
No, I agree. Nothing. Like there's the guy with the very weird voice.
I swear to God, if my brother hadn't hit him in the head repeatedly with a blender, he would have killed me.
The guy who's like, man, like the surfer dude kind of guy, he was a bit of a character. And then the music guy was also a bit of a character, like whatever happens, no matter what happens around him, he just keeps listening to that stupid music. And even when he's dead, they keep dragging him away, and then his favorite music is just playing the same music just in slow motion. I thought that was pretty funny.
That's true.
So, on a nudity score, we
gave it a 1.
Because?
There was no nudity.
There was nothing. Of course not.
Was there one person who is undressing a shirt at once? And then there is a scariness score.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you're bringing it does really look like it's leaning to the right.
We'll fix it in post-production.
Before jumping to Blood Rage, I will just quickly give Intruder an overall score. It is a simple and entertaining B-movie with some fun kills in the vein of Chopping Mall and Slaughter High. So it also joins them on the scoreboard with a score of 4.
Great. So no dips on telling what happened in the other movie. Giving a summary. I guess that's you.
Yeah, that's you, sir.
Well, the second movie was Blood Rage.
Blood Rage.
And my mom called me to ask how I was, and I have to say hello to all. She said hello, and she's fine. So I missed the first murder. So maybe someone can help me with telling about the first murder.
Yeah, okay, so...
And how does the movie start?
So start out, there's a mom and a guy, and they're making out in the front of the car, and then in the back there's two young boys, and the mom says, oh, they're asleep, so we can have sex here. Don't worry about it. But then the boys wake up, and they say, oh, mom is having sex, so let's go out. And then they walk out of the car, and then there's another car with also people having sex, and then the one boy kills the guy having sex in the other car. But then he blames his brother, like he gives the axe to his brother and puts the blood on his brother, so it looks like the brother did it. And then, so I guess there were 10 here, and then he got maybe 8 years in prison, I guess, even though he was 10 years old.
I think I got back when it said...
Oh, so he got 10 years in prison, and now they're like...
And now they're like 35 or something.
Yeah, but
they look pretty old.
I guess they're 10 to 20 or something.
Yeah.
I think I got you.
And you forgot an important detail. When the kids were sleeping in the back, then there was lying like a big gun on top of those.
And then you joined us again. So
oh, yes, yeah,
not,
yeah.
I'm not getting off the hook.
I'm not getting off the hook. I think we were discussing a lot when the movie was shot, I guess maybe 1980?
Plus I don't know.
Maybe 1978.
We'll have to fact check it.
So the mom favors Terry and believes Todd is a nutcracker. And Todd is now living in a mental asylum.
But in spite of the dramatic nature of today's outburst, I considered the setback relatively minor because Todd remained focused on establishing his innocence and getting on with a normal life.
Get me out of here! I never killed anybody!
Having a doctor that does understand him, however, the mom believes that Todd is still crazy.
Wait, so let's just be clear. Is it Todd is the one who killed...
No, Todd is the innocent, nice guy, and Terry is the...
I think Terry is the innocent.
No, Todd is the nice guy in the mental asylum,
okay.
Who was a friend.
Terry is the killer.
Terry is the real maniac. He's who
like
got away.
Terrible.
He's, oh yeah. So we are kind of 10 years forward. I think it's something like Thanksgiving. The mom had found a new boyfriend and she tries to really start a family. Terry does not approve of anyone dating her mom. So he's snapping in this moment and goes on a rampage.
Is that why? Isn't it also because Todd is back?
Oh yes, also he has an excuse for killing
him. He has an excuse because he's out of the asylum, so now he can just kill everyone around him and then just blame his
that's
brother
his,
again.
Yeah, okay, we don't know if that's his plan, but we assume, we guess that that's his plan.
Yeah, yeah, because...
He never actually does this.
The plot doesn't make much sense, so...
And the only way you can know... if it's Terry or Todd, is whether you're wearing a wig, the person's wearing a wig or not, or having wet hair or something like that.
They have a different t-shirt.
Different t-shirt, and then also...
We haven't told the viewers, like, they're the same actor.
Yeah, it's the same actor, it's like twins. So it's twins, where one kills and the other one is blamed, and then they grow up, and then now one is out of the asylum, has escaped, and the other one goes on a rampage again.
Yes.
And then now, whenever they are in the same scene, one of them is wearing a grey wig, which doesn't make any sense as they're both blonde, so...
And 18 years old or something, 20 years old, allegedly.
What is really great about this movie, if we should go to some of the great parts, we can come back to some of the awful parts, but...
Yeah.
The murders, we love them.
Yeah, they're super great. Super great murders. Especially the one where he's drinking the beer and then they cut off his hand and then it lands on the floor and you're like, oh, it's cut off, and then it starts moving again.
And squeezing the
beer can or something. That's a pretty cool kill.
Yeah, I also like the scene where he is later just sitting because he's dead and the girl comes in.
Yeah.
He's like staring him for a long, long time, like, and then pushes him and then he's dead.
Yeah, it splits in two, that's pretty
that was
cool.
A good scene.
Also.
So I think they had like a lot of good kills.
And then my favorite scene is the one where the mom is sitting in the sofa talking on the phone for like 5 minutes, and then they cut away, and then 10 minutes later they cut back to the same sofa. And then Todd is having sex with his girlfriend.
Terry
is having sex with his girlfriend, and then they cut away, and then the mom is still sitting in the same couch talking to some other people, and you don't know who she's talking with, like some operator, and she's just saying random stuff, and it's like, I don't know, it's pretty cool.
I think there might be 15 minutes of the mom being drunk on the phone talking to the operator.
Wait a minute, ma'am, are you sure you got the right number? This is 473-7896.
I'm sorry. No problem.
Before deciding on which of these two movies should be declared the winner of this episode, let's do a quick breakdown of Blood Rage on the scoreboard. The movie has 11 awesome bloody kills. It has enough full frontal nudity for a nudity score of 5. The movie wasn't scary at all and gets a scariness score of just 1.
Yes, sorry.
Yeah.
So, I guess we could discuss which movie is the winner of the coveted Ebbemonster Movie of the Week Award.
The Movie of the Week Award. I think the first movie... Intruder was a movie of the week because it had the best kills. It made a bit more sense, like the murderer actually had a reason, kind of. And then in all the boring periods of the movie, they did things to kind of make it fun, like make weird camera angles and put weird stuff in the background, and then the murder suspect kept popping up like in the background. He's just standing there randomly and popping his head in, and then I think that was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like for me, I'm going with the Terry and Todd movie. What was it called?
Blood Rage.
Yeah. Because I think maybe I laughed once in the first movie, but maybe 20 times in the second movie.
It's not cranberry sauce.
And I mean, mostly not with the movie, but sometimes with the movie, So it was very inept, but it was. I think it was more. It was more funny because, like, it didn't make it. It did not make sense at all, and I think the filmmaker is a little bit like insane, or like he does not. Like he's a little bit crazy. I don't know. He's not a normal person.
No, like he was totally absent of logic.
Yeah. Yes. And that is funny, but also sometimes it was funny because it's intentionally even. So.
Or the mom's teeth were kind of funny.
Yeah, I guess.
I think maybe. We as a civilization has come a long way in terms of, and maybe we don't recognize that, but in terms of dental care since the 70s. Maybe the joke from Austin Powers that Austin Powers have bad teeth.
Yeah.
Is we have come a long way today.
Yeah, because it was not like it was a joke that they had bad teeth. That was just the teeth that the characters had.
So I think we should just be happy that
they all had super bad teeth. Especially the moms were horrible, and then the haircuts were just like they were all using the hairspray or something. They all had ridiculous hair. Like the guys who had even a normal haircut, they had super shiny hair. And the women, they had like multiple layers rolled up in some weird...
But I think that's just... Don't blame the movie on for the 70s, 80s. Maybe that's just the fact. I found the soundtrack in Blood Rage, the Terry Todd movie, fantastic.
And in the and as you said, in the ability to be involuntarily funny, I thought this movie was mastering. Excellent. So
that's well put.
So I think this movie, in a way, by not knowing, understood its place and purpose, and therefore, for me, served me a better experience. So I would go with Blood Rage.
It could only be better after that initial score you gave the Intruder.
Yeah, well, I gave my first movie review score tonight, and I started low, and so. But I would not say what I gave of scores because I'm new in this business. I should at least rate 4 movies before I tell people what I scored.
Yeah, yeah.
So how do you feel is that such an extremely incompetent and ridiculous and terrible movie wins the first ever Ebbemonster Movie of the Week award?
Well,
by a score of 2-1.
Sometimes bad is good. I think that's all I can say. I made the top 10 unintentionally hilarious movie scenes. And
but this
I can appreciate it.
Yeah, I guess.
But this one was so bad, it was bad.
Hi.
I've lost my cat. Have you seen it?
No. But do you know what?
What?
Cats have a way of finding their own way home. And I think that you should go home too.
But it was a little bit funny, whereas the other one was so bad, it was kind of bad, but it was not funny.
The second one? That's exactly right. No, the first one.
Oh, yeah.
That's very well put.
So you have to be more bad to like you tip the score. In your favor.
But it was also pretty boring. Because it got one, like, it was really boring, but also kind of funny.
And that's what I always say in the horror movie showdown, that being boring is the cardinal sin. It's like the worst thing you can be when you watch a movie is to be boring.
To be bored?
No, boring. Yeah. For me, to be bored. Because if you watch a movie and it's beautifully filmed and great acting, and idiotic plot and super boring scenes, then it's totally not worth watching, I think.
That's a controversial...
I think like the movie I watched called Ready or Not, it was super well produced, great costume design, great soundtrack, okay acting, and then they just had the woman running around, hiding behind a tree, taking 5 minutes, then she runs, falls in a hole, walks up the hole, that's 5 more minutes, then she tries to get through a fence, 5 more minutes, then she runs down a road, meets a car, 5 more minutes, nothing happens, and that's like the most boring thing. Then I would rather look at some people saying weird stuff with ugly teeth.
I always bring him an individual piece of pie with a white plastic fork.
Yeah, but also and in Ready or Not, you kind of know what's going to happen, but people are saying things that sort of make sense, but in this movie, all of a sudden, there's the mother sitting on the floor eating beans, and you don't, and maize, like, and corn, and you have no idea why. It's a little bit interesting.
Exactly, it's like intriguing. What were they thinking? Like, where did it come from? The stupid dialogue that just...
We had a theory that they actually didn't have a manuscript, but they just had made the murders and just made it up along to kind of bind the story together between the murders. But
also I kind of like, I think the brother plot didn't really factor into the movie.
It didn't
as
really
I see it. Like it was just, you could just be a guy killing the other people. The brother didn't have any impact in the, except for the ending, I guess, sort of, but not really.
But I think it's like an 80s thing. In all 80s slasher movies, they had to have the introductory scene where the killer becomes demented of some odd reason. Either someone made a prank on them when they were a kid, or in Halloween, they show that the kid already did some killing as a kid, and now he's escaped from a mental hospital, a bit like
yeah,
this
but like
one.
You just do that without the brother, like they didn't need the brother.
Exactly, but it's like these guys, they probably saw some slasher movies and then they're like, oh, we can make a slasher movie. And then they try to imitate it, but they don't use it for anything because they're incompetent in the script department.
But they were still right, they still won the Ebbemonster.
Yeah, they still won.
Halloween has not won the Ebbemonster Movie of the Week award.
Yes. Which one, sorry?
Halloween, wasn't that what you mentioned?
Oh yeah, yeah it didn't, well it hasn't participated yet. So.
Well, it's the movie and the rule of the Ebbemonster Relevant. One movie has to win.
That's true.
Each week.
One movie has to win. And then I thought the movie was also very disorienting. It's like you see people escaping in one direction, and then some killing happens, and then they show them fleeing in the same direction again, and it makes no sense. It's like you become disoriented, and you're like, what is going on?
Because they only had like two houses and a bridge and like a small patch of forest.
Yeah, I guess it's a curse of having one frame you're filming in,
mm.
and they can't just run through the frame in 2 seconds, that would kind of be boring. So they kind of have to be in the frame for 15 seconds.
Yeah.
And that makes the running awkward.
Yeah, it's very awkward. Yeah. We forgot to.
So, yeah. Can you talk about how slow the girls. It's always a girl running away from the killer.
Mm.
And they run so, like, terribly slow and non-committed, like a light jog. It was both in the last movie and in the first movie when she was running. Anyway, that's it. But do you think you will do something to us later?
I will definitely. I'll do something to you later.
To end the video, I will quickly give you my overall score of Blood Rage. And I didn't quite like it as much as the other two guys. I loved the kills, but it was quite boring. So I would only give it an overall score of 3. That's all for this episode. I'm pretty excited to hear in the comments what you guys think of this long format for the showdown. Depending on your feedback, I may be doing it again at some point. But for now, the upcoming episodes are planned to return to form.
Very funny guys with the pig's feet.
Thank you for watching, and I will catch you later.